Why am I hiding behind this box with a Dorado sticker on it, by the way? It's because it's full of this. There's a lot of meat in here. So I've been tying up some flies for Dorado, and I came up with like a 3-material fly. It takes about 10 minutes, and it's gonna push water and swim great. Check it out, it's called the Sloppy Joe. Okay, let's get right into this. If you haven't watched our Sloptimus Prime video, there is a video on that that just kind of shows the basis behind this pattern. But as I've been prepping for another Dorado trip, I wanted a kind of a simpler idea or a simpler pattern. So I've messed around with this one a fair bit, and I'm pretty happy with it. Anyway, this one's called not the Sloptimus Prime. This one's just called the Sloppy Joe, because it's just pretty sloppy. All right, let's get to it. This one's going to be just pure chartreuse with a little black on the head. Always a good predator color. I'm just using 210 denier thread for this one, but before we get started, we're going to throw on a keel weight. The reason I put these on is because sometimes I'm casting out, retrieving really, really quickly, like the roly-poly, and what happens is the fly wants to roll. If you put a keel weight on, it's not really going to help the fly get down very well. It just helps the fly not to roll. I'm going to put one layer down. I'm going to lightly super glue it. And then I'm going to build up another layer. The only reason I super glue it is so it doesn't splay out too much when I do this part. But I'm going to do another several turns right on top of that one. And then if I pull and wiggle, it pulls that lead down into the under layer and it kind of closes it, that little break off. This one wanted to break off just right next to the other coils, so we're all set. That won't stay very good, so I'm going to take just some resin. This is Solares Medium, and I'm just going to kind of encapsulate that. This resin's plenty durable to hold up to a lot of abuse, so I'm just going to coat that bare lead with some resin. About like that. And I'll just rotate that to get it nice and round. Maybe. There's a portion of it that just does not want to play this game. Now. This is totally not critical. I just want it to look pretty for the camera. All right. So once I have this, I'm just going to shine this big light. Just get both sides there. This is quite a hunk of resin, so just move it around and boom. There's a little bump in that, as you see, but guess what? She'll fish just fine. I'm going to move the hook back to normal tying position. And I'm going to use 210 denier thread. This isn't really a super critical part. I understand there's black thread and a black shirt, but trust me, everything's going to be just fine. All right, so I'm going to use Flash and Slinky. This is the electric yellow color. I wanted a really, really bright yellow. And so I'm going to farm off a hank about like that. Let's see. So here I've got a nice hank of this. And so I'm going to pre-taper this before I tie it in. So the way to do that is you grab it about mid-shank, you come in here and you just start pulling some fibers up and through and then rotate those in your fingers. You can see I'm almost there already. So here I've got a really cool, nice taper. And I'm going to tie this in pretty long. These fibers are pretty rigid. They'll keep it their shape pretty well. So I'm just going to tie those in just like that. For the rest of the fly, we're going to use a reverse tie technique, but this is just standard tie-in. All right, I'll trim those off. reinforce those with a little bit of super glue. I won't need to do the others because of the reverse tie, but there is a little bit of opportunity for those to pull right out of there. For the core of this fly, we're just gonna use some of this squish chenille. You guys know I really like this stuff. It's just a really good filler for a bulky body like this. So I'm gonna take this squish chenille and wrap it about to the center point, about right there. And I will trim that off. Now, this is probably the most critical part of the fly. We're gonna do this in two sections, but we're gonna reverse tie some sections of this flash and slinky. So I'm gonna get maybe a little bit less than I got last time. Let's see, about like that. And I'm gonna taper it just like last time. Flash and slinky is cool because it has this really unique flash in it. That's got really fine kind of segmentation in it. All right, so I want it to be about that long. So I'll trim it. You see how I'm passing that between fingers? If you just keep tension, you can keep them pretty nice. So I'll trim that off. So now I'm going to tie this in backwards, so it's a reverse tie. So what I can do is I can just put that on my thumb and then grab it again. So passing this back and forth hand to hand can be kind of tricky, but as soon as you do it a few times, no big deal. So yeah, you can pass it back and forth like that between your thumbs, and I'm going to tie it in just like this. So some real tight wraps. I'm gonna wanna keep that on top of the hook. So you see that I didn't release with my fingers. Not yet, anyway. I'm gonna do the same thing on the bottom. Okay, to measure that, I'm going to just kind of get the same length that I put on the top. All right, so now I'm gonna take an equal number of fibers, wrap it, and I'm gonna take my thumbs and just kind of mash those around on either side of the hook. So now I'm gonna take the top hunk, and it kind of can be hard to separate them, but don't worry about it. They're all gonna kind of end up in the same spot anyway. I take my thumb and kind of rotate my thumb back and forth. And what that does is it pushes all the fibers to the side. Bring my thread up. I'm gonna pull this one down. Now I like to put a few turns before I do that to the bottom one. So now I'm gonna do the same thing and just wrap right up to the tie-in. So that's super durable. It also makes it so that there's a lot of body on this fly. Really cool tool to have for this is this Ergo comb from Loon, because I can just take that and brush it, and that helps me distribute all these fibers around the hook so that I can push them where they're supposed to be. And comb them back. It can kind of help divide the bottom section of the fly as well. And this is a tool that you want to have on the boat with you while you're fishing these, or in your vest, because one fish and these flies can look like they're all chewed up and just done. You got to throw them away. You run a little comb through it and you're good to go. All right, so here we go. The body, as you can see, they're kind of unruly, but they do eventually take shape if you comb them and set them exactly how you want. All right, so there we have it. As you can see, it's creating a hollow body. Not a lot of bulk. You should be able to cast this fly forever with an 8-weight. All right, we'll just repeat those steps as we move toward the front. Tie in some more squish chenille, and I'll wrap that about to right here. I'm not going to use the rotary feature on this portion because that tail's in treacherous territory. All right, I'll tie that off. And we'll do the same thing here in front of this clump. All Okay, once we're to this point, we're gonna do the same thing. There's just a little bit less room to work with up here. Get one pushed over, move my thread up. Sometimes it's easier said than done. So we're getting real close. So I'm actually going to take my fingers and mash this back a little bit to give myself just a little bit more room to wrap the brush I'm going to use for the head. All right. Once I have those in, I'm going to do the same thing and just brush them back to the sides. And we'll just kind of help those fibers fall in place where they belong on the fly. Alright, so you can see we've got an awesome hollow style profile already with minimal materials. And then I'm going to finish this off with an EP Crafter brush. This is an awesome color. I don't even know what it says on the package, but it's like a chartreuse with a black core. Just tie that bad boy in. Find your buddy's scissors that you don't like very much. Cut the wire with those scissors. All right, once that's wrapped in, I'm going to kind of part these to the side and fold them as I wrap. And I'm kind of all fingers right now because I want to get these first few wraps dialed in, and I'm going to mash in a whole bunch of fiber here because I want that head to build up a little bit. So if you can see, I'm starting to get some tangles back here. So all I'm going to do is take this Stomfo comb. You could use the Loon one. It's just a little bit too wide. And I'm just going to help this dubbing loop go to all the right places while I'm wrapping it. Otherwise, it won't. All right, so we're back on track. I can fold it a few more times, brush it out again. The cool thing about these EP brushes as well is that the core is very, very thin. So if you do this right, you can really build a lot of bulk there for the head. Okay, we're ready to tie this off, so I'm going to come up right here, use my comb again, and I'm going to create a part in the brush. So that I don't trap down many fibers at the tie-off point. Bring that around just two times, and then I can fold it back on itself and just wrap over the top of everything. That's a really big hook eye. That's a 5-aught Gamakatsu B10S. So I'll just stick a whip finish on this. I'm going to show you guys some other colors and a few more options of this fly too. I've got my box right here, so don't go anywhere quite yet. All right, so we've got that trimmed. Get your buddy scissors that you don't like. Brig, are these your scissors?
No, those are Spencer's.
These are Spence's? I thought they were Briggs. I actually like Spence a lot. So what we're going to do is take this brush. We're going to brush it out like this. And then if we take this in our hands and just give it the old once over, we end up with a fly just like that. So that's super easy. Just simple head, hollow type body. It swims great in the water. And I'm going to show you a few other versions that I've done. This one is the mullet variation, or the sábalo variation. It's for Argentina Dorado fishing. That's kind of what I've designed these for. So there's a dark color, This one represents a Dorado tail. So you can see it's got the orange, black, and yellow. And then check this out for more of like our toothy critters here in the States. You know, big lake trout, a big bull trout's gonna eat that one. And I stuck some eyes on this one. Look how thin that stays. And with that big keel weight, it's gonna swim great. But we'll add some recipes to these flies. And then one other really cool one that I did is this. It's an olive, kind of a gray olive and white, but a cool bait fish pattern. Anyway, there you go, Sloppy Joe. It's quick, it's dirty, but it's freaking delicious.